This poem is called Pulling Mussels from a Shell, or Pork and Beans. Seven poems for seven churches. Number 3 of 7, Pergamos or Pergamum. Antipas was like his dad, for he dealt in deliverance from decay, removing the rot, straightening the crooked, and putting a white shine on turd-tanned brown. Antipas lived at 667 straight to Heaven Street, and was the neighbour of the beast, whose pet was a wraith, a big black bugger that snorted fire. Yet he kept the faith and held fast the name, didn't act like a sinner, though he was served from the oven like a well-done roast dinner, which is unusual, because Satan usually has you for breakfast. Yet, despite his great sacrifice, the kids still played with Balaam's dice, loving a little bit of inner thigh served whilst they praise the most, most high. Sex and religion are like pork and beans, you know? Very tasty. Hiero was a hero who would not join the meat club, but fortified himself in God, knowing that the Lord had other food to eat they knew not of, which his master once shared with a large woman of Samaria around a noontide well, the outcome of which saved 1,000 souls from hell. Turf and surf, meat and mussels from a shell, or was it Michelle or Michael? Or just another bike for someone else to ride upon, I can't decide. Still, these sexual shenanigans had made an enemy of their friend, who in the end armed himself for a fight and one night would turn up at their sleazy door to slay the fat rats, whose old name was Baal, whose end was a failure to communicate holiness, and so succumbed to all that was dumbed down, even bummed meat, or meat for a bummer. So, out went the call to the overcomer, hidden food for a long hot summer, a white bald stone to remove their shame, an exclusive club and a secret name. Revelation 2, verse 12 to 17 reads, "And to the angel of the church in Pergamos write, These things says he who has the sharp two-edged sword, I know your works, and where you dwell, where Satan's throne is. And you hold fast to my name, and did not deny my faith, even in the days in which Antipas, my faithful martyr, who was killed among you where Satan dwells. But I've got a few things against you, because you've there those who hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to put a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols and to commit sexual immorality. Thus you also have those who hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which things I hate. Repent! Or else I'll come to you quickly and fight against them with the sword of my mouth. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To him who overcomes, I will give some of the hidden manna to eat, and I will give him a white stone, and on the stone a new name written, which no one knows except him who receives it." A word of explanation then. This church thought it was cool for cats, though it was really just up the junction. Despite the good that was being done, some of the mixed multitude were engaging in religious sexual sin via the compromising connection of club membership and social standing that seemingly through eating meat offered to idols brought to them. Pergamum was a bloody mess. No wonder Jesus threatened to come and duff them up. Some performance tips? Well, this poem is intentionally offensive, so a warning might be needed to be given before its performance. Still, I think it's necessary, for we live in Sodom and Jesus is coming to fight with us because of these same great sins. So, after the warning, you might become like Steve Harley, a real Cockney rebel, sleazy, bare-chested, and wearing faux furs, giving a hint to come up and see me. It's worth reading all the accompanying notes to this poem. And now for the second reading. Pulling Mussels from a Shell, or Pork and Beans. Seven poems for seven churches, number 3 of 7, Pergamos, Pergamum. Antipas was like his dad, for he dealt in deliverance from decay, removing the rot, straightening the crooked, and putting a white shine on turd tanned brown. Antipas lived at 667 straight to Heaven Street and was the neighbour of the beast, whose pet was a wraith, a big black bugger that snorted fire. Yet he kept the faith and he held fast the name, didn't act like a sinner, though he was served from the oven like a well-done roast dinner. Which is unusual, because Satan usually has you for breakfast. Yet, despite his great sacrifice, the kids still played with Balaam's dice, loving a little bit of inner thigh serve whilst they praise the most, most high. Sex and religion are like pork and beans, you know, very tasty. Hiro was a hero who would not join the meat club, but fortified himself in God, knowing that the Lord had other food to eat they knew not of, which his master once shared with a large woman of Samaria around a noontide well, the outcome of which saved 1,000 souls from hell. Turf and surf, meat and mussels from a shell, or was it Michelle or Michael? Just another bike for someone else to ride upon, I can't decide. Still, these sexual shenanigans had made an enemy of their friend, who in the end armed himself for a fight, and one night would turn up at their sleazy door to slay the fat rats, whose old name was Baal, whose end was a failure to communicate holiness, and so succumb to all that was dumbed down, even bummed meat or meat for a bummer. So out went the call to the overcomer, hidden food for a long hot summer, a white bald stone to remove their shame, an exclusive club and a secret name.